Hi, Sam here for Guitar Interactive magazine. I'm here today with the Silver Linings drive and preamp engine from DSM Humboldt. And this is a really versatile overdrive preamp pedal. There's lots you can do with this. And for the purposes of this demo, I'm just gonna demonstrate it in front of a clean amp that's being mic'd up with an SM57. This has basically, as a drive pedal, it has three different types of drive. You've got three different styles here. You've got soft, vintage, and hard. Soft mode is like a kind of blackface, kind of clean, kind of breakup kind of amp. Vintage is getting into your kind of sort of fuzzy, kind of vintagey amp sound. It's not really predefined because you can shape it quite a lot with the EQs and pre-controls, as we'll find out. And then hard style is just kind of very modern, high gain kind of thing. And then from that, on the other end, we can have it functioning as a normal drive pedal, as a mid boost, and that's in the boost section of the pedal, or we can have it as a preamp. And you can use this either into the effects return of a amp, of a power amp, to shape the front end. So if you're doing lots of fly dates and you end up with an amp with an effects loop and you don't really like the amp, you can just plug this into the return and you can shape the amp from there. But you could also use it, and as the DSM Humboldt suggests, is to use it into a speaker simulator as well. So if you've got like they've got their own speaker simulators, there's lots of other things in the market as well, but you could use it as a kind of preamp for that sort of situation as well. So I just demonstrated it on the hard setting. Let's first of all go to soft mode, and you'll see there's a pre-tone. You've got a pre kind of boost and a gain. So pre-tone changes the EQ pre-drive. So you can change the top end and the attack response to your drive sound. You've got the pre-boost as well, which is kind of like putting a tube screamer or something in front of the drive sound. So when we have the pedal turned on, as you can see, that's just the drive sound here. So this is your gain. And then you've got a three band EQ, treble, mid, and bass. And this is just gonna be really focusing on these controls here. So you've got gain, EQ, and your pre-tone. And this is the soft sound, so. Okay, and then we can change the overall volume of that, the level control here as well. We can change that maybe just up a little bit. And if we turn the gain down, we can get a bit more of a cleaner kind of sound. Let's hear the vintage mode of that same setting. Let's hear that vintage mode with a bit more drive. Sounds pretty cool. And then on the hard style, all the settings similar. Now already, with the drive control here, we can get serious amounts of gain, or we can really pull it back. There's so much scope here with the gain. But then if you want to take that further, let's just say we go to a vintage sound, okay? And we turn the gain to about midway, and we're gonna put the pre-boost here. And what happens is we can get a pre-boost and a post-boost. We can actually get a volume jump and a tube screamer kind of pre-boost into that as well. So let's just hear this setting first of all. Put the boost on. If I really want to kick that, I can bring that up. So that gets into that kind of fuzzy vintage territory. If we put it on the hard style now and we use the same pre-boost function, we can hear a bit more of a modern kind of overdrive. And then we can shape that even further by using the pre-tone. So if I turn that up a bit more, we have a bit more top end now. So this is kind of like the tube screamer tone control that you'd have. So you can really shape that EQ of the pedal simply by using the pre-tone there. Now, other options is you can change the mode of the output, the main boost here. This is actually a volume boost. If you want to use the boost as like a solo boost in a set, you can then change your pre-boost and post-boost settings to suit your needs. Either you have a volume boost and more gain, or maybe you bypass the pre-boost and just use the post-boost just to get a clean volume boost into the amp, or even to boost an overdriven amp as well. I mean, this is the thing here is it's versatile. You can use this however you see fit, really. Now, something I haven't spoken about just yet is not only can you be kind of really detailed with the pre-tone, but the EQ itself really is shapeable. So if I just go back to a kind of vintage setting, midway, here we are. The bass control, turn it up. So you can hear that adds a lot, take it away. So that's going to be brilliant, especially when you're confronted with certain amps and situations to play through. The mid control, of course, as well, bring it back. Responds really well to pick attack as well if I'm really light with the pick. Turn the mids up now, get a bit more of a middle range tone. Really nice to play with. And then the treble, of course, if we turn it all the way down, we get a very dark sound. So the EQ really, you know, gives you tons of expansion. This particular frequencies I'll write about in the review as well, about the actual frequencies that you're boosting and all that good stuff. Now, the preamp mode, I can't really demonstrate this in its full capacity right here because we need a speaker simulator, but if you wanted to get that sound as if, you know, you were going straight into a real amp, you know, a real preamp and going into a speaker simulator, this would do everything that you needed it to do. You could, if you're a traveling musician and you've got a small pedal board, you could have this and a speaker simulator. And in between, you could have a reverb and if you wanted some modulations or other effects. But this would really be your kind of EQ section, your powerhouse really behind your tone. And if you've got a speaker simulator going direct to front of house, or if you're going out into the return of a amp with an effects loop, then that's really going to give you tons of shaping options. So yeah, this is a great option, especially if you're looking for, I mean, I'm assuming most people who would buy this pedal would be using a kind of direct rig, maybe more so. And to have that versatility and quality is a great alternative to just having a kind of digital board where it's all multi-effects or amp modeling, even though that's kind of what we're going for here. To have it in a pedal format and be able to use your own pedals, and the way it responds, it feels almost better than a real amp. So yeah, really cool pedal. Silver Linings Drive preamp engine from DSM Humboldt. Highly recommend checking it out. Great pedal. All right, I've been Sam for Guitar Interactive magazine, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it and want to see more reviews, lessons, and interviews, then be sure to hit the subscribe button below and also check out some of these videos.